Hey everyone, what's up? Welcome to another quick edit video, this time with probably the last Dolomites image for a while. And for this early sunrise image, I want to bring back details from the darker areas, add a stronger golden glow to the mountain face, and maybe even darken the sky a little bit. For the editing, this time I will be using Adobe Lightroom Classic as well as some Photoshop later, and probably I also will make use of the Nick Collection plugin. So before I start, let's first take a look at the before and after images. Alright, here we are in Lightroom. First, let's change the camera profile to Adobe Landscape, which will already help with the darker areas a bit. Also, we get some more base saturation. Now, I'm not changing the white balance since the color tones look quite nice this time. Then let's work on the brightness of the image. Since it's way too dark right now, let's first increase the exposure quite a bit. Of course, we will lose details in the overexposed areas in the mountain face, but that's fixed by simply dropping the highlights. And then let's restore some more details in the darkest parts by increasing the shadows. And this time we can also increase the whites. Okay, nice. Now I want to apply a subtle soft look on this image, and therefore I'm dropping the texture. And I'm also slightly dropping the clarity. Okay, you can see, especially in those areas, it starts to appear to be glowing, which is exactly what I like for this shot. But I'm not satisfied with the saturation. I think it's a bit too strong, so I'm dropping the vibrance. Okay, and then I want to start the local adjustments. First, let's work on the gradiated filters, and you can see I have applied a few of those. Let's start with the sky, which I want to darken. So simply drop the exposure here. Then I have one gradiated filter further down. This time, since this would affect the mountains in the back, I have activated the color range mask. That means with the eyedropper, I have picked the color from the sky right here. So if I'm dropping the exposure now, only this color range will be affected. So again, let's drop the exposure. Also, let's increase the contrast here. And then let's further drop the blacks. All right, nice. One last gradiated filter left for the top part of the image. And with this one, I just want to bring back some more clarity here, since this just works great on mountains. Okay, then let's work on the foreground. For the very near foreground, I think the area is a bit too bright. So let's change that by dropping the exposure again. And I also want to drop the texture very, very slightly. Okay. And then finally, this gradiated filter, which I again want to use to brighten up the image a little bit in this part. All right. Well, maybe let's drop the highlights just a little bit. Okay. Then let's continue with the radial filters. First, I want to work on those trees in the center. I think they are still too dark, so let's again just increase the shadows. And finally, let's work on the mountains once more. Here I want to introduce some more contrast. Also, the highlights start to get overexposed again, so let's drop them and increase the shadows. And then finally, let's reduce the whites. Okay, nice. Then that's it for the local adjustments. Then I forgot to reset it, but I have applied a subtle S-curve. You can see the points I set right here. And for the color grading, I want to start in the luminance tab by making the yellow tones a little darker. So let's drop the yellow luminance. And you can see this will reveal more details from the mountains. Okay. Then I'm boosting the green luminance, which will brighten up the center part even further. Alright, now because of those changes, the colors start to look a little weird, so let's fix it in the saturation tab. First, of course, the yellow tones are way too saturated. Also, I think the greens are a bit too heavy. And I want to get rid of the aqua color tones as well. Alright, that looks much better. Then I also want to apply some split toning. And here I'm just applying a warm color tone for the highlights to make that glow a little more interesting. Then let's sharpen the image. And that's it for the Lightroom part. Now let's switch over to Photoshop to finish the editing. Now, first of course, I want to get rid of a few things, especially those sensor spots and maybe those cars in the background. So let's duplicate this layer by pressing Ctrl J so we have a backup layer. Then I'm grabbing the spot healing brush, zoom in a little bit and start painting over those dots. Okay, that was quite a bit to fix. So next I do want to check the Nick Collection plugin. And here I want to start with the polarization effect, which will help me to boost those color tones a little bit. So let's push the strength. I think it looks good this way. Okay. Then let's check it again. And this time I'm using the Brilliance Warmth filter just to make the light a little warmer. Okay. And finally, let's apply a subtle glow to the bright mountain face. And I want to use the Nick Collection one more time for this. And here, let's use the classical soft focus. And let's see. I think I'm going with the second soft focus method. Okay. Now, of course, I don't want this effect over the whole image, so I'm applying a layer mask. And by holding down the Alt key and clicking this layer mask icon, I'm already creating a black layer mask. Then I'm grabbing the brush tool and set the foreground color to white. And now just paint in the glow effect. Alright, and that's it for editing this mountain landscape. I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions, then please feel free to ask in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.